The really neat thing about nanobubbles is, one, they're very small. The kind of bubble that you would see in soda water might be, let's say, a millimeter in diameter. So the nanobubble, the diameter at 100 nanometers is 10,000 times smaller, but that then means that its volume is a trillion times smaller than that bubble that you can see in the club soda. They last a long time in the water, and so that can then make them really useful. So if I can have that little bubble that wants to stay in the water, that then very much allows increased amounts of gases to be present in the water.
They're pretty amazing entities that you could use in different industries. I'm very excited about this research because of the potential applications these nanobubbles can have in water treatment. Ozone is a really strong oxidant that is used in water treatment for water disinfection, but it's also used for degradation of micropollutants. And so we can deliver ozone, which is a gas, into solution more effectively than we can disinfect and also degrade micropollutants in an energy efficient way. So what makes it so unique about the way we generate these nanobubbles here at the University of Calgary is that it requires 100 to 1,000 times less energy to make these nanobubbles compared to conventional methods that are out there. We're adding the ultra pure water to the tank so we can first saturate it with the gas.
The water is fully saturated with as much gas as the water can hold so that the nanobubbles can form.
The way we generate nanobubbles is the generator is going to rotate, and what it's going to do is that we're going to also apply an electric field through those cylinders to the solution, and that's going to help nucleate the nanobubbles on the surfaces of those cylinders. So after we produce the nanobubbles in water, we check if we have them with our in-house device with a laser pointer. You could see that the nanobubbles are scattering the laser pointer. So what we're seeing here is similar to what we were doing in the lab, where we are shining a laser. So here we have an instrument called nanoparticle tracking analysis. What the instrument is doing is shining three lasers. We need the three lasers to try to highlight the different sizes of bubbles that we have in the solution. And so the nanobubbles are scattering the light. We're here investigating the fundamentals of how we can make them more energy efficient so we can translate them later into many other applications, not only in water treatments.